and welcome back to Candy's Classic Game Shrine, everyone. Today I'm doing a peripheral review, or a accessory review, and it is going to be on the Amiibo Power Saves. This is the Amiibo Power Saves here, and this is the original Power Saves for the Nintendo 3DS games, just so you can see the difference. Personally, I don't really use my Amiibo as competitively as other people, but I like the idea of being able to back up and have multiple saves on my Amiibo, so I decided to purchase the item. I've had it a couple of days now, and I would like to give my review on it. Only a couple things I'd like to mention, and then I'll show you how it works. First off, I really like the design of it. Unlike this one, there's a lot of detail on it, and it kind of catches the eye. When you place an Amiibo on it, it'll light up blue here to indicate that it's read properly, which is really nice, where this you kind of have to wait until it loads. Excuse me. On top of that, this is really lightweight, lighter than a deck of cards, and about the size of a deck of cards, maybe a little bit smaller. One thing I have to say, I absolutely love the people at Daytel that have finally made this Mac and PC friendly. I've been having to dual boot or share my husband's PC for a while, and the fact that I can just run this on my laptop now, it just makes life so much easier for me. So, hell yeah, kudos to going and getting this working on Mac finally. Now, as far as when you plug it in, the interface is kind of boring. The original Power Save for the 3DS, you can actually see the list of the codes on their website, as well as when you plug it in, you can choose from a list. When you plug in the Amiibo Power Save, you basically just have to go through a menu and click through. You'll see that later on. I'll be sure to point that out. Aside from the kind of meh interface, the amount of options that you have to customize your Amiibo is actually pretty awesome. You can choose which game you want to save it and mod it for. You could also do stats like defense, add items, change the appearance of your Amiibo as you scan it, which is kind of what I take advantage of for my customs and things like that. One thing I did notice, you don't need a registration key like you did for this one. You can pretty much just install the software and take this with you anywhere you go and you're set, which is really good. You can have multiple saves, like I said before. It's really simple. You just put it on top, scan it, and then you hit save or restore, or you can delete all of the data in one go, and takes just like a minute. This does not support the Splatoon Amiibo, and I would assume the Yarn Yoshi, Chibi Robo, and Animal Crossing ones as well, because they're fairly new. But it does support the Smash Brothers line and the Super Mario line of Amiibo at this moment. So, let's jump cut and I will show you how it works. Okay, here we are. This is my MacBook. We have the Power Saves plugged in and we have the Amiibo. Now I'll show you what shows up when you scan one that isn't supported, and I will show you what it's like to scan the other two lines. So let's start up the Power Save. There we go. This is the Splatoon one. Now, unlike when you scan them to a Wii U, you have to leave the Amiibo on the scan pad or else it will disconnect. So, this is what happens when you put characters that aren't supported at the moment. There's the blue light, like I was mentioning before. So, you just take them off. Man, my allergies are bad. Okay, so here's a Super Mario line that I customized to look like a Toadette. You leave it on the base, it tells you how many saves you've made, and the number of games that you've used it on. Click that, and you're brought to this main menu. This button really shouldn't even exist, but whatever. I like the fact that it's the color of the Super Famicom buttons, it's a nice touch. You have your backup, your restore, and then you can apply your cheats here. Your backups, you just type in a name, and then hit that, and there you go, total of saves, two. Boom. You can restore it, just click whatever you want, and then you hit that. Here is the interface I was telling you about. This is what it looks like, which is a little weird. I would rather just like a drop-down menu than this, but we'll see if they change it. Here are all the games that it supports, and you can just reset the save data from here. We'll just go to Mario Party 10 for the sake of it. base codes. You can do all these different things here. For the sake of this video, I'll just do this one. And when you select it, you're automatically brought to a prompt screen, and then you can do this. And it's really that simple. Boom. And then you just remove it from the base. And we'll take this Charizard here. Now he has no saves and no games. Let's back up him to whatever, this random stuff. We'll apply a cheat for Smash Brothers Wii U. Appearance code. Sure, we'll do appearance 3, why not? And that's really all it is, guys. It's that simple. I mean, would I recommend it to everybody? Yes. For the simple fact that you can have multiple saves on your amiibo, the thing is worth it. Even if you're not into modding it, because I personally can give two shits about modding it. I personally just bought it for the fact that I can have multiple backups and saves now, and just so I could review it. The product overall, if I were to give it a rating out of a 10, I would say 6.5. It still needs some work to be as polished as the original Power Saves, but honestly, in the beginning, this was a piece of crap too. But now it's really stable, really awesome, and the support for it is fantastic. So, yeah, if you need multiple saves on your amiibo, definitely go out and buy this. Otherwise, just wait and see if this gets any better in the future. So, thanks guys. If you have any questions, don't forget to comment, like, subscribe, and ask. Take care.